Number two, Dale Anderson, Nick Vogelsang. Boy,
Vogel
there's somebody
Giesang.
We haven't.
Dave, it's Vogel Giesang.
Yeah.
Okay.
But there's a match that we're going to see some very similar styles. Both players, Jennifer, cup the ball and hit it with authority.
David, we know Nick can strike, but now we know that Dale Anderson can strike because he had a 789 in the qualifier at Seymour Lanes.
Pure roll, look at that.
Very pure roll. That's a great way to put it.
In a nice, soft delivery onto the lane rather than lifting it out. At age 23, he could throw it down the lane halfway if he wanted to, averaging 209. 789, and this is his first time on television. 200-300 games, not too shabby.
The first one when he was 18 years old.
Goat.
I always wonder what's going through somebody's mind when they're on their very first time of television.
It's been so long ago, I think it was black and white when I was on the first time. I can't remember.
David,
look at
throwing
this ball.
The new AMF XS. And is it a fantastic ball?
The white whale, huh?
Is that what it is?
Yeah, well, I don't know what they call it, but take a look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Soft roll. Look how deep inside he's playing. Going up out the 22nd board. Head pin going to the wall, coming off, tripping out the four. Whipping into the seven pin for a strike. Nick Vogelsang is amazing, and this ball looks fantastic.
David, I was talking to Nick before we started this morning when he was practicing, and he was motioning driving away a car. Of course, Jeff Weiler every week brings us out a car, and in the case of a 300 game, we are going to have them drive it away.
And you know what? Out of 31 years, Jennifer, we've only had one on television. I've got a premonition. 1995. We're going to do it. Oh, what a bad break.
That was a very bad break, David. The scalp just going in front of the 10 pin narrowly.
Let's take a look at it here. The 5 pin and the head pin. Head pin, I believe, going to the left-hand wall. There it is right there, going to the wall, careening off, coming back. Oh, no, and then it tripped into the 4.
Yep.
And then the 4 was blocked out by the 6 pin, which was in the channel. Cross lane for the spare, look out.
Very good. That will get you loose when you are on TV for the first time and you throw a hook like that and you make a 10 pin.
Well, I like what I see in this man's game. It's controlled power. His average, what's it say there, Jennifer?
He's averaging 209.
209.
At a local center.
At one of our local centers, ABC, the American Bowling Congress, is out and about and sanctioning the establishments all around the greater Cincinnati area. They are the ones responsible for the quality of the games that you are seeing, the conditionings that are on the lanes. They are the governing body of the sport that you and I love. Nick leading by 11 pins, the white whale doing the job, and once more, it's twirling.
David, that ball is working so great for him. He's created just an enormous amount of area on that lane. He can get it wide, it's going to shake out. He can get it high, he'll trip the 4. Flush in the pocket, here we go. It's going to take this head pin. Whirly bird, wham, bam, it's out of here.
Nick, the powerful release at the bottom. He just rips the cover off the ball. Maximum revolutions. That time going through the head pin. But again, the wrist roll, the cup. Let's take a look at it. Powerful, powerful lot. Watch this, folks. That is beyond description. He actually gets more revolutions on the ball before it gets to the arrows than I do in 60 feet.
And that good revolution and power is very good for that spare because you have to get through to get back to get to the 9 pin, the sleeper.
We want to thank all the people that came out this morning, and we want to invite you to come out and watch the taping of the show. We're going to give you a little bit of information a little later on in the telecast on where we're going to be, and some we're going to even throw some goodies your way to kind of bait you to come on out and watch us do the show.
David Dale Anderson is just throwing a fantastic ball right now.
And here's why. Look at the position. A big man, but he stays down, gets through the ball. Now watch this go off the end. Head pin going to the left side of your screen. Nothing really to take out.
Just, absolutely, just power. controlled sheer power,
Jennifer.
We've seen
wild power players before. This man is as smooth as I've seen to create
trip before. That's exactly what's going on. That is exactly what we're talking about. When you roll the ball cleanly like that, you are going to trip fours all day long.
Two pins separating the two players at this point. We're halfway through our game. Two pins, absolutely nothing. Right-hand lane. Nick cutting the ball a little short that time. Cutting through, leaving your favorite spare, Jennifer.
Oh, yeah. I love the 3-6-10. Typically, I move seven boards left with my feet, using my same strike target, with the exception of whether I'd be playing a very outside line. Look out. Oh, not typical of Nick's spare shooting at all. Going to the outside of the spare.
The Miller scoreboard tells the tale. Five pins the difference. Nick not happy with either one, but you know what? Maybe, just maybe, he was trying to find the pocket while shooting the spare. We've done that before, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, that was fantastic there. Nine pin was history.
This is a great shot, ladies and gentlemen. Watch the ball as it enters the 1-3 pocket. Do not take your eyes off of the ball. No deflection. Nine pin's going to be the last one to go down right there. And did you see it? It was hit by the ball by about an eighth of an inch, and then taken out cleanly with another pin. Controlled power, here it is.
Fantastic, he's snapping out that 10 so nice, David. I'm impressed.
So am I. Again, a new player on the scene, but in Cincinnati, we have the talent. All the organizations in this city have promoted bowling for years. The AJBC program, the junior bowlers are fantastic. We'll put them up against anybody in the country. The women bowlers, yourself, for example, qualifying against the men for week number one. We've got it all here in Cincinnati. But he doesn't have all the area to the right that he tried to use that time.
No. That was a totally errant shot, and he's left himself a rather difficult spare, the 1-2-4-7. Of course, with his type of ball, David, I would say that he has the roll, so he'll roll all the way across those pins.
The exact point I was going to make, Jennifer, if anybody is going to have more of an advantage making this, it'll be the big hook player, because chopping it typically won't be the problem. It should run straight down.
And it does.
Yes, it does.
Thanks, Dale. You did a good job.
Great work by the guys in the chat.
Yeah, fantastic.
And we predicted it. Nick, on the right-hand lane, taking no time at all. He is going to get up and just wail away at it, and he just strikes at will.
This ball is great for Nick, but he's got to get it right. That is the key. He has to get it over there.
One pin separating the two players at this point, Jennifer. They're just going at it hammer and tong. Nick Vogelsang trailing by one pin at this point, but he has the strike working. He's on a double. Look at this.
Fantastic. Great correction. And that's why Nick Vogelsang is the bowler that he is in this city. He is just an absolutely clutch player.
Well, he is going against a newcomer, but I predict we're going to see this particular gentleman again and again. Too much talent to be held down.
Again, first time on TV, kind of typical.
Exactly, Jennifer. That's a good point. He's got the talent. He's got all the moves. He's got the equipment. What he lacks is the experience, and he lacks 13 pins at this point. He's shooting the very difficult 3-6-9-10. But again, the big hook player, a little bit of an advantage here.
Perfect. Dale Anderson is very well composed this morning, making difficult spares, striking with great authority. And he's only down 13 pins going against Nick Vogelsang.
A clean game.
Fantastic.
Through eight frames, Jennifer. And again, composed, striking when he can, making his spares when he cannot. But again, against Nick Vogelsang, if you don't shoot 230 or better, your chances of winning go way down.
That is a disadvantage of the big hook. There it is right there, plain and simple.
I'm going to go out on a limb. I bet he makes this.
Okay.
You know?
He's the right, again, the right kind of ball to make it.
Ladies and gentlemen, if he makes this, take a look at this setup, if you would. We're going to be looking at the 2, the 4, the 8, and the 10. He's going to try to slide that 2 pin over like a combination. It's hooked off.
About, not a bad try.
Yeah, that's
Dave.
Not a bad try at all. Yeah, so much for my prediction.
No, I think it was a great prediction. Indeed, it's a very difficult spare, but you just never know with that type of ball.
That all but salts it away for Nick, unless he creates some terrible mistakes, which in years past, he was capable of losing a match in the 9th and 10th frame. But Jennifer, he's matured into the kind of player now where if he's got 20 pins on you going into the 9th and 10th frame, you can just about plan that the party's over.
Chris Lucida from AMF, of course. He featured the XS ball a few weeks ago in qualifying for the King of TV. And I was very impressed, and of course, Nick does it very good justice.
Yes, he did.
There's a little ball change on the fill ball, David.
Well, just going to play around, see what's out there, experiment a little bit, because he knows he's going to be going up against the King shortly. And if you're going to dethrone the King, you better be able to throw some strikes. Now, we're going to ask our audience to do a little kind of, not informal, we're actually going to make it a formal survey. Please, if you're not taping the show now, please pop a tape in and do it. If you don't have a VCR, call your buddies, pop it in. We would like to hear from you. We want to know what we're doing right, what we're doing wrong, and we want to try to correct anything or improve on it anytime we can. You are our audience, and without you, we would not be here. So get a pen and a paper, because in game 3, we'll give you an address in which to send your comments. I'm not sure I can rebate you on the postage, but we would surely appreciate the comments, and we're looking forward to making it better for you.
You bet.
So get your pen and paper ready for game number 3, and we'll give you that address. We'll pop that up in game number 3, but again, we're looking for not, we don't want just the positive comments, folks.
Exactly.
We want everything. If you're unhappy about something, we'll see what we can do to change it. If you like something, we'll make sure we keep it. We'll try to do the best we can.
Again, David, Dale Anderson has no reason to hang his head, and I really genuinely hope to see him back to see what his second time on TV could do for him.
Well, we have a couple of 3 or 4 weeks left here, so he's going to finish out with probably a 205 if he strikes. Nick Vogelsang, however, our winner at 231, so not too shabby. Let's see if he can finish with a flurry. Nope, going a little bit high. 204 is not going to be enough to defeat Nick
Vogelsang,
and he will be going against our King, Mr. David Wellage, in just a few minutes. So don't go away. We'll be right back with some more fantastic bowling.